Welcome to my channel Technical Maiti, and today I again represent you another very good tutorial. So today is our topic is how to create a bootable USB drive. So have you heard the term bootable USB drive? So before I show you the steps, let's speak some word on bootable USB drive. So friends, bootable USB drive means you can easily format your computer by this drive. That means in a previous idea I stated that you have to download a ISO file, that means image file of a which operating system do you want to install. Suppose Windows 7, Windows 10. Suppose okay, I show you some. As you can see here, suppose I make a drive of this Windows 7. As you can see here, this Windows 7 image, this is OS image file. That means which OS bootable drive you want to make, you must that OS image file. So okay, so suppose I want to make a bootable USB of Windows 7. So at first, which software is need that Windows 7 image file? So okay, and there is a good software which is useful to make bootable USB drive. Its name is Rufus. So go to Google Chrome. Just type what I type, R-U-F-U-S, okay, Rufus. So as you can see here, this is Rufus. So just enter. So as you can see here, Google is also sharing you the knowledge about Rufus. Rufus is a free and open source portable application for Microsoft Windows that can be used to format and create bootable USB flash drive. So you can also read it on Wikipedia. So okay, you just click on the first option. As you can see here, so here is a question in your mind that how to download this software. So just scroll down below, and as you can see here, this is in the download section. Go to Rufus. To this is the latest release. So okay, last update, just click on this. So as you can see here, this is most probably this is a very small size, 945 KB, less than 1 MB. So okay, go to downloads. So go to show in folder. So as you can see is the Rufus already downloading. So okay, just close all of this, and here I also disconnect your internet. So okay, so and friends, another thing is you had not installed any this Rufus software. This is a exe file. That means you just double click on it. It take permission from you. Just select yes. Just press no here. As you can see here, no device is detected because I had not insert any pen drive or other USB drive. So this is not detected. So let's plug a USB device. As you can see here, I insert a USB drive. So let's again check with Rufus. So go to downloads. So just double click on it. Yes. As you can see here, my USB drive is selected automatically. So that goal is you have to put a USB drive. So cc.com0, this is my USB drive name, and it is automatically selected. This is the fantastic software. There is no competitor of this software, Rufus. So okay, and the option is some fast reading, but I show you each and every step. So okay, the fast device is automatically selected. This is the second option is if you have a modern motherboard, support like Asus MTBR, latest motherboard, Intel 7th generation, 6th generation, 5th generation motherboard, then you go with GPT partition scheme for UEFI, because the GPT partition scheme for UEFI is ultra modern. If your computer is less than 8 years or 7 years, 10 years ago old, so go for MBR scheme for BIOS or UEFI. So okay, so MBR means MBR means here this is a old partition format style, because in 90s or in 2002-03 in the age the MBR partition is very popular. So but after 2015 or 16, after 2012 or 13, the GPT partition became very popular. So so if you have a modern motherboard, so before proceeding the installation, go to the your motherboard manufacturer website and select either your motherboard supports UEFI, either your motherboard supports UEFI or not, also read documentation on GPT. So if you have a modern computer, suppose 3 or 4 years old, or a modern laptop 2-1 years old, I keep you this GPT partition. This is the third option. So this is a modern and best option. Okay, GPT partition. And another thing is the in GPT partition, the hard disk failure risk is less. That means your OS image is separated into different image location, so different storage location. So MBR, so the GPT is better than MBR. So okay, I left this option GPT. So okay, GPT partition style. So and FAT32 make is default, and all are default. Okay, so here you have to, another thing is dust, go to the image file. So my OS is Windows 7, so just go to here, I select my OS. Okay, OS Windows 7, just select. Okay, so okay, as you can see here, Windows 7 is selected. So just double click on start. So I have not start here because I have already made a Windows 10 Fall Creator Update bootable. As you can see here, after making bootable, this type of option is here, boot EFI setup. So this is the procedure. So after that start button, this is the green loading bar is automatically come, and there is a pop-up is here, your bootable drive is ready. So and the speed is which time is consumed depend on your computer configuration. If you have a high computer configuration, 8 GB RAM, Intel Core i5, i3, i7, then the process is less than 5 minutes. Or if you have a dual core or any other processor, the process is takes longer time, like 5 minutes to 10 minutes. So I here just close this. So okay, so after making the USB, this is the files look like this. So just go to your computer BIOS settings or in any other boot option, and then you can easily format this. So okay friends, this is the process how to make a USB bootable drive. So okay friends, if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe among with your friends, and don't forget to comment. So if you have face any trouble or problem, just comment below, I can give you the best solution.